Hey everybody, it's Drogith here with Into StarCraft Cup number 3 on the European server. This is a third place matchup between CrazyGitar as the red Zerg player in the lower left hand corner of Blistering Sands, and Xerox as the pink Terran player in the upper right hand corner. In the last matchup, we saw CrazyGitar being heavily pushed into his base by some Marauder and Marine forces that were just continually. Well, they just kept reinforcing and forcing. It was like an Energizer Bunny worth of infantry forces. They just kept applying the pressure. Xerox just kept pushing it on, kept producing the units, and Crazy was locked inside his base. He got to expand every once in a while, but again, that expansion was taken down, and he was just not able to amount the resources needed to stave off any type of attack. Now, so the matchup is 1 win for Xerox, 0 for CrazyGitar. This is a best of 7 matchup. 1 to 3, no, it's a best of 5 matchup between these two players. So, and as I said, the third place matchup. Now, Terran and Zerg, very interesting setup on this map, especially with it being the third place matchup. Some good skill, a spawning pool going down at 14 with these destructible rocks in the back, and being able to spread the creep along this very short rush distance across on those back rocks. Very good technique for the Zerg player to use. I thought somebody was bugging me. Very good technique for the Zerg player to use. One to get sight of almost the entire map, and we have a fast expansion going down by Crazy right to his expansion to the north, and at the same time Crazy is blocked out of Xerox's base with the two supply depots and the single barracks going down, pumping out Marines. Now Crazy does Xerox does have the one gas down, so it doesn't look like he's gonna go too heavy on a for Marauders or Reapers or anything like that, as there isn't even a tech going down yet. However, it might go down now that Xerox has moved his drone out of the way. We do have an Overlord slowly making his way over to the base just to get some extra sight. Gas going down, or an extractor going down for Crazy, so we will be getting the speed wings eventually, though it is a bit late to be able to get that tech right away. Looked like he was trying to get his expansion up as soon as possible, get those resources that he did not have access to on the last map. Now we do have a tech lab going down on that barracks that blocked off the ramp, with a factory right next to it and a second barracks just to the right of that one. So we have the one Marine, double barracks, factory. So pretty standard build up for a for an infantry army with some tanks as backup. Yet we do have a tech lab going down, so with tanks as a backup. Not much else going on. I'm surprised there aren't that many SCVs being produced on Xerox's side. However, he is doing pretty good keeping his energy down, keeping the mules going, and as you can see, 16 SCVs, 17 and 17 on the drone side. So actually we are kind of drone light, as normally when you go fast expansion you go extremely heavy with the drones to maximize that that income that you should be getting. Also be spreading the creep. Nice creep tumor down there, already spreading it. Second gas going down for Crazy. As you can see, the speed boost is going up with Hellions coming up. Hellions, a very nice harass unit very early in the game. You get three of them, you can slide them into the back of the base, and you can almost one-shot these drones right out of existence. Crazy has control of both the Xel'Naga towers, getting that excellent sight like we were talking about earlier, as he does spread his creep just a little bit, going up and down between the two bases, making it easier to traverse the distance between the two bases very quickly. On the backside, we do have reactor going down with on that second barracks. So we do have the Hellions. We don't have anything training in the tech lab, surprisingly enough. It just kind of looks like he's people are macroing up, though we do have an armory that just finished down. So we have Thors. we have the capability for these big bad guys. Now, Thors, early in the game, if you rush Thors, add in a couple of SCVs, and you can really clean up the house with that powerful unit. SCVs automatically healing the Thor, and it just seems like it almost seems overpowered, but if you can target the SCVs, then there's no problem with taking care of this tactic. Income side, it looks like Xerox might have stopped making the SCVs, where Crazy has gone full force into getting those drones out, as well as just finishing up on his layer tech. And roaches are out on the board with that evolution chamber right behind it on the back side. I hate when you miss stuff when you're talking about something because you're explaining something on the map. But anyways, we do have that Thor out. He looks like he's got a little rocket pack on the back. Let's look at him from this side. Yeah, look at that. He looks like he has rocket packs on the backside. This base actually picks up, so the Marine Marauder, single Hellion, and Thor army can begin to push out, a nice slow push from the base, as Xerox is doing Stimpak, trying to get it finished up before he makes it all the way over to the other side of the base. Gleal Reconstitution going down, getting that extra speed for the Roach is very important to do. Especially off the creep, but you get them on the creep and they can do some serious damage. This Hellion gonna go down very quickly to these Speedlings and that Spinecrawler. Spinecrawler taking a jab at a Marine, just waiting its time, waiting for this Thor to come in. And as we can see, the Thor is just gonna start. These Zerglings need to run right past these Marines and go right to the Thor. Get a nice surround on that Thor, and it looks like that Thor is quickly going to go down to all three of these roaches in the Speedlings. Thor does go down. Now would be an excellent time for Crazy to push in, and he chooses not to push in. We do have another Thor. It's almost completely pushed out. However, nothing happening. Hydroden coming out as a reaction to that Thor. It's actually about halfway done, so it looked like he had planned on going the Hydra Roach army anyways. But some nice research going up for Crazy. Hydralis then just now finishing, and several more roaches coming out as opposed to the Hydras coming out. Concussive Cells is being researched by Xerox, as well as he's putting down a tertiary base. And I don't know, he's just running a single Marine out here. Look at that, he's running like crazy. It looks like he's been stimmed up. And he's just trying to get all the way across the base, trying to get some very quick scouting done. Yep, that stim did wear off. As you can see, his health did get taken down severely. And here we go, Crazy getting his changeling into the mix right over here. Possibly not going to get... Nope, he got noticed by Xerox right away. Very nice job by Xerox, noticing that changeling in there. Combat shields going up as concussive shelves had just finished. Two Thors on the board. And we do have the Groove Spines being upgraded for these Hydralisks. A nice little Zerg army composition over here, as this Creep Tumor is spreading out the creep just a little bit. Something to note, two Creep Tumors right next to each other will spread the creep a lot faster. Just, you know, a little fun fact, a little FF in case you didn't know. But here's Crazy putting down a Changeling, and he is warping into... I don't know, he's just kind of staying like that. There you go, Changeling warping into a Marine, and he's just running around the base. Let's see if Xerox notices him one more time. And yes, Xerox did notice him right away. Stim going up on that Marauder for some reason, just to run up and to get to that base. There is no hidden tech back here, so I'm not sure why he had to stim up to get it. But right now, Xerox and Crazy are just opting to build up their armies and spread the creep out. Some creep tumors going on the back down over here, so getting sight of these back rocks. Very nice job by Crazy. However, this slow macro game is kind of killing me a little bit. Oh, we have a Nidus network going down. This could be some serious trouble for Xerox. That pink Terran player, he does not have any missile turrets down. He doesn't have anybody in this back area, even especially with that Overseer dropping changelings down. No type of defense coming in the back over there to stop that from happening. And another changeling coming down, trying to get some type of sight, seeing if there's any extra tech. And Xerox has not even gone up with any extra tech. He's just... Well, the changeling is dying, but He's got those, look at that, 34 Zerglings are in production right now. Holy cow, how did he get that many Zerglings in production? I don't know, but that's absolutely insane. Crazy has his overlords over here. It looks like they're around the keg. I don't know, maybe listening to some music. They got trance music going on. And all these units are moving into the Nidus Canal. And on the other side of the Nidus Canal, we do see it popping up in Xerox's base. And it will scream when it comes out, and these units will just absolutely stream out of here. Here come the Zerglings. We do have movement from Xerox going to the wrong base. His base is going to get absolutely overrun with all these units coming in. If he dropped a queen in here, dropped down a couple creep tumors, that would be awesome. But it looks like we do have a base race going on right now, as these three Thors and this infantry army is trying to push out against everything that's going on. We've got a bunch of speedlings in the back over here. Gonna try to beat up the Stim goes up with all these Marines and Marauders, easily taking out all those speedlings, and these Roaches and Hydras, no match for this ground army. However, with this giant Zerg army just coming in, absolutely destroying everything that Xerox has, if this is a base race up to the last building, there is no chance at all that Xerox will be able to do it. However, Xerox does not have, Xerox notices that it's the base race. Crazy does not have any anti-air units at all, as far as air-to-air units. So getting to these bases off in the corner, these barracks and whatnot, he will not be able to do it. However, with all the Zerg that he does have, he has plenty of units to take out all of these Thors, all these ground forces, and especially when they're stimming up, they've got no medevacs to heal them. They're just going to go down. One Thor goes down, a second Thor is almost all the way down, and now here come the Hydras, a bunch of changelings in behind them, and we still have all these units back here. Looks like those extra tech buildings going down, and yes, that army was completely taken down, and Crazy says that he sees them flying in the corner. So all we need is a mutaden to go down, or a spire mutaden. That doesn't happen. So we do have a spire down, and once that finishes, we will have the air units able to chase them. Xerox realizes this, and he calls good game. So Crazy takes game number two. It is tied up 1-1 with these matchups. And Xerox is, there he goes, Xerox leaves the game. So yes, it is tied up 1-1 after game number two. We can move on to game number three now, and let's see how that turns out. This Drogith checking out.